am high. Hello and welcome to another edition of the DJ Sounds Show here in London. Now, I've actually got a really special show for you today. We've got three residents from Red Hot Party Fuse in London. We've got Enzo Siragusa.
Hello.
Rich next.
All right.
And Luke, what was your surname?
Miskelly.
Howdy.
How are you doing, guys?
All good.
Fine.
Good.
Very good. Indeed. You good?
We've got a special show. You've got 2 hours. Now, obviously, there are a couple of squabbles who was going to play first or how you were going to play.
Get
but
your bangers out, innit?
You're just going to lay it down for the next 2 hours, aren't you?
Yeah, basically.
Definitely. Yeah.
Excellent. Now, who wants to say a little bit about what Fuse actually is? Maybe Enz.
Well, I think it's a number of things now, isn't it? It's a party. Done many Sundays. It's two record labels. A lot of DJs and a lot of residents.
Yeah.
And that's something that I want to touch on later, because it's quite unique, isn't it, that it's residents only?
I mean, it's not just residents. We do have some friends playing and stuff now. But, yeah, I mean, it's built around a core group of DJs, and that's evolving and growing now, which is really cool. Yeah. It's all come from the dance floor, man.
Yeah. The way it should be.
Yeah, man.
Exactly. So, without further ado, I think, Luke, you're going to get going first, aren't
okay.
you?
Okay, am I? All right, then. Fair enough.
Go, get
Luke.
On the decks.
Just been told by.
Get on.
And no playing my tunes.
I haven't got any more playlists, actually.
So, we've got the Fuse residents in the house here on the Pioneer DJ Sound Show.
Cool, Luke.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If you could slip another one in, always slip one in. This is the Fuse Residence Takeover here on the Pioneer DJ Sound Show. So that was Luke Miskelly in the house here on the Pioneer DJ Sound Show. Luke, get round here. I want to have a word. So that was Luke in the mix. We got Enzo Siragusa coming up next. He's just going to limber up over the other side. But Luke, come on, get cozy, get cozy.
I'm getting cozy.
So did you enjoy that?
Yeah, it's a lot more difficult when you're on camera. It gets a lot hotter as well behind there.
It
seems a lot cooler here than it did over there, put it that way.
Sounds of the deepness.
I like it.
Yeah. What kind of... because obviously Fuse is made up of its residents. So what time of the night do you normally play?
It depends. I mean, we've kind of been, I'll say, trained by Enzo to play at all times of the day. Yeah, at all times of the day, you know, be prepared for anything, basically.
It varies, doesn't it?
I mean, obviously Fuse on a Sunday, I've done warm-ups, which starts about 3 p.m. Last week, or a couple of weeks ago, I did a closing set, which was brilliant. But essentially, the elements of the music are all the same, basically.
So basically, always versatile.
Always, yeah.
The Enzo Bootcamp trains you so that you can handle any situation.
Basically, that's exactly right.
Yeah. Okay, now, off air, we were actually talking about Ibiza.
Okay.
It was a lot of fun, wasn't it?
It's going to be a lot more fun for me this year because I'm going to be there for the whole season. But yes.
I was thinking you might say that.
It was fun, definitely. Brilliant.
Excellent. And are you back at Sankey's? Can we announce that yet?
Yeah.
We are. Every Tuesday. Make sure you're there, everyone.
So Tuesday's at Sankey's in Ibiza. It's going to be a lot of fun.
But yeah, I hope so. It's going to be a lot of fun, definitely.
Any particularly memorable aspects of, if you can remember, from last
year? For me, the closing, I wasn't sort of scheduled to play.
That was 24-hour party, wasn't it?
No, it wasn't 24 hours.
Fuse closing.
Yeah, not the Sankey's closing, the Fuse closing. And I end up playing at the closing, which I wasn't billed to originally. But that was a highlight for me personally. A great party as well. If I don't mind saying so myself.
Now, productions. Did you play any of your own tracks in the mix?
Yeah, first one was... I'm not sure I'm allowed to say this, but it's called Gutter Slut.
Is a gutter.
Not slut. So that's a track I produced alongside another resident, Itetsu. So that's hopefully... Well, I haven't discussed it with Enzo yet, but hopefully he likes it. hopefully he likes it. A good friend of mine, Archie Hamilton, a remix he's done for a guy called Daniel. So two, basically.
Mm. Nice. Now, Rich, you've been releasing on Fused, haven't you?
Yeah.
It's Fused London, isn't it?
Yeah, there's two labels relating with Fuse. One's Fuse London, one's Infuse. And I've released a few EPs on Fuse London. And at the moment, just got one track coming with Seb on Infuse. That would be the first thing I've done on Infuse with
we've said, or at all. So that's really nice to kind of like branch out of a track on Infuse as well, because I've really.
What's the difference between the labels?
Difference. Different design on the label.
apart from that, Rich.
Come on, Enzo.
Explain it to them.
maybe that's one for Enzo when he comes around.
Fuse London is the residence, and
Fuse London's residence. Infuse, I think, experimenting with kind of like, I mean, I kind of started off doing kind of dance floor tracks a bit more.
Fuse London is a bit more outside the camp, coming from other people on the label, inspired by. By the Fuse sound, really.
Yeah.
I think we'll go a bit deeper with Enzo.
On he's that the man one with all the knowledge.
Just give me my computer back.
Excellent. Now, both of you, Record Box, were you using it?
Yes, we have been.
Excellent. Because we had a little training sesh, didn't we, about this time last year, and I think I got that out a projector and almost had like a red laser pointer. But
we were in a classroom, weren't
we? Has it made life easier?
I've kind of moved away from Traktor to Record Box, so there are a lot of similarities. I mean, personally, it's a lot easier just to stick in your USB now. And the concept of Record Box, the looping, the cue points, does make things a little bit more creative and easier, really.
And who's the colour fiend? Who loves tagging everything up?
I think it's Rich.
Well, I've done some colours, but I think Ross is the colour fiend from what he says. He's been going with colours for a while on Record Box. Myself, I've been using it for doing a lot of looping and kind of samples to use it like a third CDJ. To kind of add extra moments and colour to like more stripped back tracks, for that I think Record Box has been great, because you can get your tracks into the beat grid, but you can also get your samples in the beat grid and kind of do a lot more kind of creative things with them. Definitely, really helps.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Nice one. Well, I think Enzo, are you limbered up? Are you ready?
I'm all ready to go.
It's going to be an audio assault.
Rock and roll.
I'm going to get my bass line going.
Well, thank you guys. We're going to catch up with you again after Enzo's mix, but thank you, Luke, for that mix. So this is Enzo Siragusa in the mix here on the Pioneer DJ Sound Show.
See, all of us think we see the world as it is, but in reality, we see the world as we are.
Thank you. that I want. I just don't want to force it. If it sounds forced, I won't do it, you know? I don't usually like to rhyme. And not to say that I won't rhyme. I just don't like to force it. If it sounds forced, I won't do it, you know?
Enzo Siragusa in the house, bringing his mix to a close. Whoop, whoop. Enzo, get round here.
I think they're running.
Leave that running.
Leave it running.
I'm enjoying it. So Enzo. Did you enjoy?
I did. I always enjoy, man. That's what I do.
So lovely, deep, lush, rolling, groovy vibes there.
Yeah, just you know, just sort of roll with it. You just go and see where it goes. Up, down, left, right, a bit of everything, really.
I mean,
a few bass lines for sure.
I mean, off air, you said that, you know, you just love 3 hours to just.
Yeah, it takes me about an hour to get into it.
We did have a good session before this.
Yeah, we did. Yeah. We were having fun before, all three of us jamming and playing around with the effects and stuff. Yeah, it was good to do that because I don't have this mixer at home, so just playing around with those effects, man, having a bit of fun.
Excellent. Now, actually, would I be right in saying that Fuse is a little bit of your brainchild?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, you know, there's a few of us behind it, and certainly, you know, it's definitely not just me, it's the guys as well, you know, from a creative perspective, you know, not just the party, but also the sound. It's definitely a group thing for sure.
Nice. And that really comes across, and that's why I wanted to get all up. Well, there are many of you. We've only got a few of you.
There's quite a few more of us. I don't think we'd have enough space in here. Yeah.
But in a nutshell, can you tell us kind of how it came about?
I mean, it started as an after party Fuse. It was a bit of an afterthought because we were doing other parties at the time. And Sunday really was like, it was a carry on, and it started on a very low budget, long sets because we couldn't afford to have anyone play. So it was just a few of us. It used to start about 10:30 in the morning till 10:30 at night. I think it was 11 in the morning till 10:30. We used to do very much an after party, and it just evolved from that, really. It grew very quickly, you know, and we've done well
since 2008.
November 2008 we started. Yeah, 23rd of November 2008.
Oh, look at this numbers.
So. We've done hundreds of parties. So
and you've probably got a biggie coming up for Easter. Yes,
we have. Yeah, we got Premiersku doing a live set, which is they're really amazing live, you know. This is proper live, a lot of gear.
Yeah,
three of them, you know, really properly jamming with a lot of analog gear, which is the kind of live I'm really into. So very excited about that. Rich, you're playing, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm playing.
Rich, myself and Samuel Bellis, who's another exciting prospect, you know, one of the guys that's come from the dance floor, proper vinyl head. Yeah, so it's going to be a good day.
Excellent. And you've just got so many productions sort of coming out and in the process, haven't you?
Yeah, we've got loads. I mean, Luke played one of his new ones with a Tetsu just before. I'm pretty sure Rich is going to play pretty much his stuff. Rich is prolific, let's just say that. You know, he's relentless. I played quite a few new ones. I've started a collaboration with Alex Kidd called it's our Kilimanjaro project, which is very much exploring sort of house and our roots, which were both of us come a bit from sort of drum and bass. So you've probably heard a few bass lines. Yeah. I worked those Pioneer speakers out a bit there.
Very nice. Yeah. So, I mean, but do you think your sound, I mean, I'm not going to do the journalist thing, so please describe your sound. But I mean, there's a lot of different elements, isn't there?
It's a London sound, you know. I really truly believe that what you each resident is slightly different. But one of the things is that it's all coming from London, and London's always been a melting pot of music. You know, you know, we've got the jungle sound, which I'm from. Luke and Seb came from more of a garage sound. Rich was as well from the hardcore jungle era, like me. Yeah. You know, and we kind of progressed through so many different sounds. You know, like house and techno you know, so we've kind of been through all of it and evolved. So I think you're hearing a lot of those influences right now, you know.
Yeah, it's kind of got that maturity to it, hasn't it?
Every person changes and grows, and I think that's what our sound has been doing, you know, certainly since we moved to Village Underground, and we have a bigger sound system there, and it has a bigger feeling, that room, you know. Our sound has maybe got a bit tougher and a bit more ravey, you know, which is wicked, because it's, you know, as DJs, it's fun for us, you know.
Yeah, I mean, where do you think that kind of sound is actually at? Because, you know, at the poppy end, you know, a lot of it has infiltrated the charts with sort of Gorgon City and Disclosure and stuff. You know, do you think that's
in the charts?
do you think that that's kind of helped you? Have you noticed your audience change? Well, or do you think Sunday is like your barrier to entry?
I've always said, the crowds are forever changing. The sound is always, people say things are getting commercial, this, that, and the other, but it's always done that. I mean, I've seen Ibiza, that happens in Ibiza like about three times already when people say, no, it's dead. I'm like, actually, I've been going there for, since 95, 96, and I've seen it evolve and change. And I think every time it does that and things are getting poppy and commercial, actually there's a space for something underground, So it's a never-ending cycle, isn't it?
Yeah. Nice. Now, you've got another one of your trusty residents coming up in the mix, haven't you? Do you want to give him a little bit of an introduction?
Well, it's, like I said before, he's prolific. I mean, he's a cornerstone of our sound. He pushes all the boundaries at Fuse, to be honest. As a producer, he's really evolved our sound. And, tracks like Bristle that he made, which was... an amazing track, and the whole EP, if you listen back to that EP on Fuse, it was just it kind of changed our sound, and he keeps doing this, and you're probably going to hear a few more of his tracks.
it's funny like that, because you never know as well, you just kind of try things out and
He definitely dries things out.
And I love that you're rocking the old Pioneer headphones. Very, very nice. So without further ado, I don't want to eat into your mix anymore. In the mix, this is Rich next.
for your body.
Bye.
Next in the mix here on the Fuse special on the Pioneer DJ Sound Show. Rich, get around here.
How you doing?
So as this 2 hour mix concludes, it's Fuse takeover. I love it.
Yeah.
Three DJs, three very unique sets. Awesome stuff, guys. Did you have fun?
Yeah, loads.
Yeah,
very much so.
Yeah, definitely. Glad you enjoyed it. I think we did.
Always.
Excellent. So moving on, we're fast approaching summer. Ibiza is looming. Who wants to give us details about that? Maybe Enzo?
Yeah, so we'll be at Sankey's every Tuesday. So we've moved from the Wednesday to the Tuesday. Really looking forward to it. I think we've got some wicked lineups, and you know, all the guys playing. Again, we're going to be very much focused on our resident DJs. You'll see a few artists that have come through Infuse as well from outside the camp, which is cool.
Nice.
Because we're starting to, you know, find some new talent out there, again undiscovered really. So giving some new blood an opportunity, which is great. I think it's important. But then, you know, there'll be a few friends of Fuse. You know, more established names.
And how many weeks are you going to be running?
Got
for
19 parties.
19 parties. Ow.
A lot of fun. Hopefully I'll survive this season. I ended up in intensive care last year.
How many was it last year?
So yeah, it's a few less, but yeah, I mean, we're starting early in the season, 27th of May. We kick things off and we go till the 30th of September.
Okay, great.
Every week.
Now, obviously, anyone who's got into your sound today, how can they hear more? How can they check you out? Where are the parties and how can they get hold of you?
So, you know, online our music's obviously on Beatport. Some tracks are vinyl only. We do one track on each Fuse London EP is a vinyl only track. But everything else is on Beatport. Otherwise, you know, get down your local record store, go to Juno or Dex or someplace, and you'll find that the records, best way to hear it is to hear it at Fuse.
Which is?
Where it's on a Sunday at Village Underground. It's not every single Sunday, but I mean, check us out on Facebook. You'll find us on there and you can get all the details there.
So that's Fuse London, yeah?
Yep. And then obviously we'll be in Ibiza for the summer.
Okay, and what about SoundCloud?
Yeah, we're on SoundCloud. Yeah, so I can't remember the exact address, but yeah, Fuse London. And you'll find all the Infuse stuff on the Fuse London SoundCloud as well. Mm. And then individually, we're all on there. So so yeah, just get digging and you'll find find the tunes.
And just to recap, Sankey's, what day of the week?
So every Tuesday.
Every Tuesday for 19
weeks. It's Fuse Day.
Fuse Day.
Oh, nice. Fuse Day,
Fuse Day.
Nice. See what I did there?
It's a
very clever, right?
Excellent. And are there plans to take Fuse out on the road? You know, other sort of parties?
We've done a few things. Yeah, we did. I mean, we did Sankey's in Manchester. Mm-hmm. We did we've done a few showcases. Yeah, we did Switzerland and we did one in Milan. So, you know, they're coming in again.
Do you take the family?
Yeah, well, there has to be a few of us there. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, that's a prerequisite. Yeah, has to be a couple of the Fuse boys at least.
Mm. Nice. So, yeah. Now, hopefully, by the time this goes out, you'll also be able to check out the lab show, which we're going to record with the guys.
Yeah,
where we're going to go deep.
Yeah.
We're going to talk residencies. We're going to talk.
As deep as you can go.
Really deep.
Barry White deep. I want to know all about the residencies, how it works, playing those different times week after week, working with that regular crowd. I mean, and you guys really care about sound, don't you?
Yeah, we put a lot into it. I mean, you know, we did when we were at 93. I made them change the whole sound system. And when
make it go up to 11?
yeah, and we've done the same at Village Underground, and yeah, I mean, we do that everywhere we go. Really, I'm pretty anal.
Because I mean, your music is quite physical, isn't it? You need that kind of physical force.
I feel that sound needs to be dynamic, you know, and it needs to come across, and especially for our sound, where you know typically it's been pretty stripped back, and you know, you need to hear everything that you've put into that track.
And no distractions either.
Yeah, I think a lot of clubs these days, you know, especially going back to the more, you know, the EDM, I nearly said a swear word there, the EDM stuff, you know, it's focused, you know, there's more noise, and whereas there's less in ours. And so you need to have a good sound, and a good sound system is essential, really.
Definitely. Nice. Well, guys, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
Nice one, man.
Sweet.
And don't forget to check out all the other shows on YouTube, and that's Pioneer DJ Sounds. Thank you so much for watching and listening. See you next time. Goodbye.
Bye.
Laters.